Hey everybody, Dan's here, Seals is King, tip of the day. Been thinking about this quite a bit, and the tip of the day is lose the term no decision. Lose the term no decision. And what do I mean by that? So a few years ago, Corporate Executive Board came out with a statistic that said that 58% of all B2B pipelines are stalled at no decision. And while I think that's interesting, and I think that certainly there are deals where you're dealing with just tire kickers, what I believe is that sometimes salespeople are using this term as a crutch, that now there's this new term called no decision. But at the end of the day, it's no go, it's no deal. And we have to work to overcome this. So I thought today I'd go through a few reasons perhaps for customers going with no decision, and then maybe ways that we can overcome that. So, you know, first and foremost, the other interesting stat, right? The 58% number is interesting, but there's another number that came out, I believe, from Richardson, which said that only 7% of salespeople get a second meeting. That is eye-opening. Only 7% of salespeople get a second meeting. So, there is a huge amount of sellers today that are not demonstrating enough value in these introductory meetings, which leads me to believe there's a lot more work that we can be doing to get us to advance and to not get into the stall mode. So, you know, definitely number one is we have not delivered enough value if we're going into no decision. And the way we deliver value is we've got to uncover the issues, the problems, the reason why we're meeting. Not only that, but we have to understand the impact of not solving those problems. What will it cost the prospect today if they don't address it? How big of a priority is it? So we've got to get under the covers. We've got to start speaking about and learning more about these problems. I know we've said it quite a bit, but it's critical. Again, and the impact. The other thing that might happen sometimes is that you bring up the solution or your product too soon. Or you go in and you're just doing the old school pitch and talking about you, and then you walk out of the meeting and the prospect's like, you know, I have no idea what we talked about and we're not moving forward. So that's another reason. The next reason could be you haven't sufficiently uncovered what the buying process is. Who are the individuals in the buying committee? How does it work? The person you're meeting with could be a champion, it could be an influencer, or it could be a decision maker. We need to find all that out. We need to find out who's going to make the decision. We need to understand who's going to be involved in the next meeting. The other thing we have to do is we have to gain the commitment of that individual to support us, to move forward. Before we leave, we have to ask him or her, you know, do I have your commitment to move this process forward? And what are our next steps? And let's get that next meeting lined up. A couple of other reasons. You may not have been empathetic enough. You know, we talk about this quite a bit. Did you empathize? Did you deploy your active listening? Did you confirm and reiterate that, you know, this is what you heard? Did you play it back? Did you ask follow-up questions? Did the prospect get the sense that you really understood what he was saying? That could be another reason. And then the last reason that comes to mind is this whole term of risk. You know, one of the reasons in a study that we talked about earlier this year why buyers don't buy is that they say the salespeople do not understand the risk that the buyer has in making this decision. So, you know, do we understand the buyer risk? And then how do we handle that? And one of the ways we talk about in Sales is King is we talk about actually turning the tables a little bit and demonstrating to the prospect the risk of actually not moving forward, the risk of the status quo, the risk of the current situation. So these are a few tips that I'm thinking about, but I really think that the term no decision is dangerous to us in sales today. And we've got to overcome it, we've got to eliminate it. Tip of the day.